It's just the two of us. But the dead bear really freaked me out. Ernie. Remember the dead bear? Well, we're gonna see it again. Wait, how do we beat the demons? Yeah, we do. Well, there's this one demon that me and my friend tried to, beat, but, we couldn't. And we died to the damn demon. It's just a quiet, peaceful intro until I'm ruining it. You ready to get flown into the window? I mean, you ready to get thrown into the window? But now you can. Can you? Here's the windows we're gonna get thrown into. Be ready. Not the grandmother. Oh my God. And now you understand it's a grandmother.
Our story begins within a warm Slavic home. Toasting next to the fire, the children's grandmother tells an interesting tale.
Sorry,
of course.
Ernie.
It is an ancient Slavic tradition that would hold many secrets of what was holy and pure and what was dark and unclean. An almost terrifying tale, but the children weren't too keen on believing such fairy tale nonsense. It would almost seem as if they disregarded any interest in a grown man's fiction. The grandmother finished her tale, and the children, even though completely uninterested, respectfully sat through the entire telling. Afterwards, they decided to go play and frolic in the snow and travel amongst the nature that gave the country such a staple of beauty.
Tough pig? Who the fuck is Tough Pig? Precious butt. Shorty. Short suit boy. I said short suit boy. Shorty.
Now outside, with no more than 5 houses, the town was so small, yet so confident with the style of living. From the houses of which they lived, showed a semi-narrow path downhill towards a thickly and naturally decorated wood. The children began their journey through the thick snow and followed without a care in the world. But where will this tale, this adventure, take the children?
Your watch. Just come over here. Do you think we're... Wait, how old do you think the kids are? Besides him. I think they're 15. I'm just saying, I think they're 15. You wanna see what the Music Man, wait. Ah! It's Bink! It's Bink! Huh? Alexa, what time is it? I can't read no digital fucking clock! Watch! 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 This is what... Look! Music Man! What is he saying? I can't see what he's saying. For you? If you have a phone, check it. But don't worry, I got it with my friend tape. Touch the portal! Mine is online, but I don't think he wants to play.
Upon coming from the split path of which they took, The children observed the birds flying by and the trees piercing the sun rays, as this cultivating scenery always takes them by disbelief of how unbelievable this seems. They continue on the path to further seek their location of play and curiosity. Their own personal wooden hut.
I got the axe. Did you get that last time? Did you get this last time? Yeah, this. If it won't let you pick it up, that means you got it. Just imagine me going like, to somebody's head. Yes, I got murder on my mind. There we go. Hold up. Excuse me, ma'am? Music man? Where the fuck are you? Dude, no! Come back! If you don't get back here, I'm going to chop your head off. I don't care if it said put the axe up, but I am taking the axe. I'm not a child. Are you coming? Here's all of my recents. Oh my god!
Bruh!
What are you talking
about?
Hey, who are you?
Justin? Stay put!
I said, where are you?
Hold up! I'm done! Might as well put the axe up anyway.
Wait, what axe? Who are you
talking about? I have an axe!
And I'm not afraid to murder your booty and play a nickname. I swear to God.
What?
The holy Jesus!
Where are you?
I'm by the walls.
Go to
the walls.
Oh, I know where you are now.
Wait, Danny.
Bruh. Music man! Quit being so slow, dude! Oh, there you are!
Hey! That's what we met!
Wow. Hi. Hey, it's still me, Raven. I just changed my in my display name.
Why you call me Raven? What the hell is that thing?
That's my friend Music Man. But I said it's me, Raven. I just changed my display name.
Oh, hey Raven.
And outfit.
And hey Music Man.
Yeah,
this
up
is
the
like
one.
A party.
I told him to stay put, but didn't listen to me.
Wait.
Yes. Yes, I told you to stay put!
I prayed to the Lord that we would not die.
Oh, we'll see. We'll see. We'll see.
I prayed to the Lord that we will be safe and bless us on this journey of killing Krampus' dumbass little deer. Oh, that's in me booty, bro. I can't freaking ask a question, bro. Oh, that's Krampus a Christian with that axe.
Oh yeah, there is a part where you have to run from him.
Oh hell nah, that damn nigger.
Yes!
That skinny ass whore ass nigger is about to fucking chase our ass.
It's not gonna be
We're really gonna die.
Just
right
change
now.
Back to your normal outfit and quit copying Lunar.
Lunar's my butt. Wait, Lunar?
Yeah, I have a friend named Lunar.
Hey, he copied you! He's copying you!
Not me! Not me! Your normal outfit, dumbass!
Here, I'm gonna show you my outfit. A party.
There we go!
Hon! I got the balls, bro!
We're all tall.
I got the balls to kick ass and take names! Here we go!
Well, I can't leave y'all. Let's go.
It's for me, God. Be more than my man.
Music Man! Get your little ass over here!
You short ass little skinny booty man! Hey, is this a short person? This is really not even my height. You really not even my height.
Ooh!
You're not even my height. You! Raven!
Bitch!
You're not even my
fuck
height.
Fuck you!
Hey! Go suck Krampus!
But we do get chased by Krampus, though.
Oh, hell no. We're getting chased by that fat bitch?
Yes!
No, Krampus actually ate a child!
Bitch, what?!
He ate a whole little girl! I was like 3 years old!
What the hell?!
Yes! What the what?
Music Man, come the fuck here, you little ass bitch!
No. I'm a crackhead when I say boo. Krampus sucks dick.
But literally, you get chased by his ass, and then, you know what? I ain't even gonna spoil the end.
The children finally arrive at their play hut. It was made of wood and not very sturdy, but they found it such a treasure, as they felt it was at such value, such fortune, They would not trade a thing in the world for it. So, they decided to play and explore the setting.
Guys, I'll be back!
As if it was their very first time in such a beautiful, cultivating winter wonderland.
Where? You're going to the store? What store? What, Dollar Tree?
Oh my god, it was just on your head! What? No, it's not going yet. Let's go in when it gets dark, What about bro? Remember when we see Saul Krumpus right there? But... yeah, but he ate a literal fucking 3-year-old. A damn 3-year-old. The bitch was 3! Need to collect it again. Can I stick my head out the window? No. No, I can't. Music man! Get your ass!
With the time setting to dusk, and the sun grows ever more sleepy, so do the children. One of the children suggests that they had better head home, as it isn't getting any brighter. So after 3 hours of play, they decide to go back home for the day. They grab their lanterns and set off to the path.
You are. Don't invite bro. Dude, tell him not to join. You! That was good. Better not. Or maybe... huh, he's still in his dorm. Wait, which music man? Call him off-brand. I want to see what he does.
Absolutely shocked and worried to the bone. The children want to go kept on time and had definitely paid the price. It was now almost completely dark and the wind grew ever stronger. But they had no choice but to continue through the piercing, roaring winter winds.
Looks like we go the left way.
dude, wait.
Who is I gonna invite? Alright, Justin. Look, I have fire powers. I have fire powers. Huh? Powers. And just shut fire. Oh, I burnt my glove. Is he just chilling in his dorm?
Yeah. Music? Oh my god!
You scared the shit out of me. Dear my lovely children, I've been preparing for my return. Yes, I know. So for now, I will send you letters through your uncle until I come home. In the meantime, take good care of your mother for me. Plenty of hugs and kisses. No shit, Sherlock.
Stand back, bitch! There we go. Oh my god, no. Decline the invite. Wait, should we go see what happened to the side of the house? Lacey? Huh, nothing happened.
There was gonna be like...
scratches and shit. Music man! Quit going into the dark. Music man. Wait, I gotta... Oh wait, right. He's my friend. It'll tell me when he's online. Wait, I'm gonna send him the blood picture. My friend, the guy we were just with. What if I make a chat with you two? Why don't you change your name to Music Man? Your username, Music Man. Huh? Why don't you change your name to Music Man? Your username to Music Man. Yeah, it's a, like you, Music underscore Man or some shit. Justina, there we go. Indeed. Bitch. You did not. The dead bear has no organs and shit. Did you know that? Did you know the bear has no organs and shit? Oh my god, stop! This was the bear that killed our father, and it was just slaughtered so easily. Whatever we're dealing with is not human. Please tell me you did not invite Lunar. Ernie, quit farting. Music Man! Great, now Lunar's with us. I was gonna save a spot for... I'm running. It's fine. We can just play with Justin after this run, right? Lunar?
What? I'm lost in like a very dark place and I can't see.
Just walk forward!
I am!
Keep walking!
I'm like... I spawned at the start.
Music Man, stay!
I can't...
Because you like the dark so much! I'll go find Lunar on my own! Stay! Loon?
Yeah?
Oh my god, fucking Mason, no!
There you are!
Okay, come on. Follow the girl with
last
the lantern.
Last time when I held the flashlight, I got yeeted back 50 miles out of the map!
Believe me, I did that too. Music! He's not there. I told him to stay put.
There he is.
You gotta stop it! You scared the shit out of me. Okay, follow the blood.
Yes.
bear. The slaughtered bear that
Everybody
killed the dad.
To get yeeted 50 miles back.
Huh? What?
We're going to be yeeted 50 miles back on the next level.
Bubbly yellow.
Every time you take a step. Because that happened to me and I was just stuck in the void.
Yeah, but the trick is not to hold it close to your chest. Because that's how you get yeeted.
Yeah.
Why? Were you holding it close to your chest?
I don't think so.
Alright, y'all, we gotta climb. I'm holding the lantern and the axe. Because I know what I'm doing.
Okay. Okay.
Lunar?
Shit.
The sun?
And the beach.
Right, Lunar's alone because we forgot to party up.
Fist bump, Lunar. Once Lunar gets in here. No! I was telling this thing no. Lunar! Fist bump!
I got lost. In a different universe.
If that happens, I just got yeeted back, but...
Works?
What?
Rec Room works, like, if you get separated and we're in the same game, is it like you're in a different universe every time you join a game?
Oh, no. Music Man, you remember how to do this one, right?
I have never played this game in my entire life.
Yeah, but, like, you know, do you remember how to, like, how stealthy to put the fire down, the stuff down? Alright, that's your job. Doing fires and shit.
I'm running.
Lunar, wait! What the?
Oh no! You're walking backwards.
No lights, no smoke, no signs of activity. No one's here. We're all alone. Quickly! Quickly!
I'm running as fast as I can!
You did!
Why do we have to go over there? Why can't we just go into the other house? Break in and-
All players must sleep together anyway! We're all in a party and you're going anyway, Music Man. Page. Oh.
I'm scared. I'm scared.
You're what?
I'm scared right now.
Read. Reread!
I'm staying it behind this chair.
Well, too bad.
I'm staying.
Ah!
What? You jump scared by him again? I think she got jump scared by you again.
No, leave the lantern there, guys. Leave it. Fire and... the fire's gonna be your job. You stick with me. Lantern is my job. Get your hands off of it.
Quick, be stealthy.
Get the fuck...
What?
No! Music Man! No! I said fire is your job. Your job.
No, you dipshit.
What do I do?
You stay beside me. Come on. Stay beside me. You know how to get this one? Me and my friend died.
I thought you said this would be scary! lied.
Yeah. I'm already saying
I lied, Lunar.
I don't know, bitch.
Can you be quiet? She keeps inviting me, and I've declined 2 times, which means I'm busy. And have you checked my profile and said if you could request to join? No, you haven't. So the room's full. That's what is good. The room's full, so leave us alone now.
Music man! Get back here! Ah, we can jump!
It's behind us!
No, it's not! Lunar! Lunar, it's not behind us! We're okay!
Yes! What the fuck?
It's okay, Lunar!
I heard the growling! I looked behind me and I just saw its face! And then I got...
Well, you better get ready to run from... Hey, I said the axe was my job.
The axe and lantern is my job.
Actually, no. You take the lantern. I don't want it. The axe is mine. Bitch, what the fuck? Bitch, no! Oh my god, Elizabeth! Stop it!
I swear! With my bare robotic eyes! I saw it right behind us! When I heard the growling, I'm serious!
That is not a damn bear, Lunar!
I swear I saw the blue man himself, aka the knockoff of Purple Man. Yes.
Are we literally thinking about FNAF now?
Yep. You just dropped it, didn't you?
Okay, axe is mine, lantern is Music Man's. Let's go!
Stick? This
axe, mine.
I keep glitching!
Is that an axe, mine?
I'm coming! Oh no, it's chasing me! Ah! I'm gonna run for my...
Take the damn lantern, Music Man. I don't want this piece of shit.
My face.
Go. Wait till it says run. Okay, go, 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 go.
Okay. I am going to die.
His ass is coming. His fat ass is coming. Fat ass Krumpus. Fat ass Krumpus. Fat ass Krumpus.
I'm really gonna die.
Hey, fuck you, Soup Boy.
Oh god.
Yes, I'm chopping up Soup Boy right now. I said yes, I'm chopping you up right now. We did it!
We did it?
Oh wait, right.
I don't know where
I am. No, we sleep! No, sleep! Just go to sleep.
Okay.
Just
all I see
and that's the point! You're supposed to sleep!
With a warm welcome of the morning sky, the children sit up as they were completely laying down. Curious and confused, the children look around to seek answers, but find none. Unaware that this was all just a horrible dream, they gather the things once again and go home for good.
Wait! That chair!
What
that chair that was sitting up, it was supposed to be knocked out. Grandma!
You son of a bitch.
Hey, we beat it, y'all!
Yep.
See,
I'm
looter?
Totally not traumatized.
Did you think those things were Wendigos?
Yes.
It looks
like a Wendigo.
Krumpus.
No, it looks like
that
a
was Krumpus. Krumpus.
No, it looks like a Wendigo.
It's Krumpus.
Got the head. You mean Krampus, the guy from Christmas?
Finally arriving back, The children quickly rush back to see their grandmother waiting on them, excited to tell her your horrifying adventure through thick and thin. She briefly interrupts you and asks, My children, it seems like you've seen the devil himself. She offers you to come inside for a warm breakfast and another story to tell. Confidently, the children decide to listen this time in case anything else happens abruptly. Before she enters, the children ask, What could be any worse than this past tale? There definitely couldn't be anything worse. More scary.
More scary.
She responds, Oh, children. This tale is much worse to experience if left vulnerable. But in case you haven't heard of this, let me ask.
I feel like...
Children, have you ever heard the tale of Krampus?
That's Krampus. The guy from...
Krampus!
We're in a vehicle or something. Wait! Did we get kidnapped? Oh, he's inside of you.
Ew! 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 Ew!
He's inside.
Let me move, you son of a bitch! I'm getting my camera. Bitch! Give me... How the fuck? How the fuck did you get here?
With the event of Corchin coming to a close, so does this story. Although I'm not sure what's quite worse. The ending of such a wonderful adventure. So terrifying,
so dark,
coming face to face with children.
Here it comes!
But I still don't know what's worse. The fact that the tale that we told has to come to an end so soon, or the fact that the children thought all of this was a dream.
Yes!
Save it!
The crumpet?